Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. Good morning. I hope you guys are doing good today. So right now, there's a bunch of controversy brewing on social media, and I'm here to spill the damn tea, okay? So what's going on is this. Nobody at all. Then here comes Sesame Street. Billy Porter is coming to Sesame Street. He's bringing these fierce vibes to Sesame Street for season 51. So, of course, this is causing a lot of controversy. So they posted a picture of Billy Porter in a tuxedo dress. I believe that's what he wore to the Oscars, I believe. And they're calling it Oscars the Grouch. LOL. A lot of people are really mixed about this. So once he posted that, Billy Porter responded and he says, y'all talk about iconic. I was tickled to meet Aunt Elmo and the gang at Sesame Street. And then he goes on to post pictures. Now, initially, people thought the picture was Photoshopped. They're like, you know, give it a chance. He's probably going to come on there wearing, you know, a T-shirt and some jeans. Well, that's not what happened. Okay. Per these pictures that have now come onto social media, he was fully dressed in his tuxedo dress, no pun intended, with Elmo and a bunch of other characters. He was even sitting in Big Bird's nest in his tuxedo dress as well. So, of course, this is causing a lot of controversy. And what I really find interesting is that everybody in the LGBT community is not for this. Mr. Ray had left a comment on the Jasmine brand, and basically he said the following. He said, I feel conflicted. I'm openly gay with 5 nieces and 3 nephews. I allow them to identify and act on their own, and appropriately I respond. I don't believe in exposing children to everything. Let them learn the basic fundamentals before we start giving them alternative views. So he got a bunch of likes, and there were several people on my Instagram page as well who were from the LGBT community, and they were leaving very similar sentiments. One gentleman says, as a gay man myself, I do think it's a bit much. They should let children be children and leave the extra shit for adults. Here comes the gay agenda narrative in 3, 2, 1, laugh my ass off. So I replied back to him and I was like, LOL, you already know, bro. The conspiracy's coming in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But yeah, they're doing too much nowadays. When the mainstream starts normalizing child drag queens, I was too through. There's a lot of comments. People are going back and forth. So I said, well, let's bring the dialogue to YouTube, being that my page is private, okay? So let's talk about it here. How do you guys feel about this? Do you feel like, you know, Sesame Street is doing the most? They're trying to push an agenda. And these young kids should simply be learning about counting and ABCs and not learning about fierceness. Me personally, I don't have a personal issue with Billy Porter. You guys know I watch Pose, okay? That is my show. He did a phenomenal job in Pose. He's a brilliant actor. I really enjoyed his character. Now, he's been doing a lot recently on the red carpet, okay? Let's not forget his Grammy look with the moving shade hat. Which to me was just funny. I've never seen a hat like that. You know, Billy's about his fashion. He's about his makeup. Now, I think for most people, they wouldn't mind Billy being on there if he was just like in jeans and a shirt and it wasn't such a play on his sexuality and the way that he dresses. I think that's what's bothering a lot of the people who are commenting. It's not that they don't want to have gay people on there, but it's like, why does it always have to be an over-the-top gay stereotype? So I think that's where some in the LGBT are coming from. You know what I'm saying? Because let's keep it real. Many people in the LGBT community, they just dress normal, like normal people who are straight. You know what I mean? T-shirts, jeans, dresses, you know, things like that. It does seem like the mainstream is starting to do a bit much. You know what I'm saying? I don't mind gay people going onto Sesame Street, reading books and stuff like that. But for him to have to do it in this huge, over-the-top tuxedo dress, you know, after a while, it just starts to be like, is it really about the children? Or are y'all just looking to make noise and get attention and stir controversy? Because we know that controversy sells in this day and age, and it definitely brings eyeballs to the show. Because let's keep it real. I mean, unless you have tiny children, who's really checking for Sesame Street? I haven't watched it in years. My kids are, you know, damn near grown. So I haven't watched it in a long time. But even my nieces and nephews, they really don't watch Sesame Street like that either. So this might be a way for them to drum up new viewership, but they're definitely getting a mixed response. Some people are super happy. You know, don't get me wrong. There's a lot of people who are for this. They're here for it. And they love the fact that he's on there with his tuxedo dress. But then there's other people who are like, no, this is just doing way too much. This is making a mockery of the LGBT community. So I'm here to, you know, give you guys a platform to talk. And let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. How do you guys feel about Sesame Street allowing Billy Porter to come on there with his tuxedo dress and talk to the children? The episode has not aired yet, but just the pictures alone are stirring a lot of controversy. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit that like button. And most importantly, don't forget to hit the notification bell so that way you can be down with the notification squad. So let me know your thoughts. All right. Deuces.